it affect you when you read a poem that you've forgotten? Is it like reading something written by someone else?
Well, this time I was just faking it because, for the purposes of continuity, I had to read this poem, but I hadn't read it for some time, and I left out a verse, and I'd forgotten the meaning of the whole poem.
Does this in any way disturb you? Isn't every poem a part of you as a poet?
Well, it doesn't disturb me because I don't think anything was at stake. But I think that the message comes through, you know, with the body, with the eyes and the voice. You could really be reading the instructions from a shoe polish can.
What's the point of writing poetry then if you could just as well read instructions on how to polish your shoes?
Well, it depends. You know, if you want shiny shoes, then you want to. If you want people to have shiny shoes, you want to write those kind of very good instructions. And if you want to polish other parts of yourself, you do it with poetry.
How can you relate the writing or the creating of a work of art with an act of polishing shoes?
Well, I don't know. It depends how far you're looking. You know, it depends exactly where you've got your binoculars trained. If you stand far enough away, it's probably the same thing. You know the story of that juggler who performed his acrobatics and plate balancing in front of a statue of the Virgin? Well, I think it really comes down to that. You really do what you sing.
Is that the key to your diversity?
I'm all in one place.
Well, I don't know.
Well, I think that the borders have faded between a lot of endeavors, and people are no longer, I think, capable of those kind of poses like the poet. On the mountain with the cape, and or the singer, catering to the masses. All those kinds of expression, I think, are completely meaningless. They don't mean anything to me. It's just a matter of what your hand falls on.
No one sees. myself.